Thank you. First of all, I want to apologize over the last couple of years, I was unable to be here because the job I have now, I was working for another organization in Tampa, and they made my schedule, I made my schedule. Now I make my own schedule. Even though I'm in the process of moving to Tampa, I make sure that I'm off the day off to be here. You know, as I say here, I think Aaron alluded to it early. You know, as I look around, the only guys in the room that I played with, went to the dressing room with, was Ezell Bills and Al Downey, how he came back from the service. But at the same time, I knew about just about everybody in here. Even through my older brother Robert, played baseball up there, or even through Shaq James Harris. And the good thing about this, I always look at, if you're from Grambling, you know, and I see Coach Lee, who, you know, through the days was up my office line coach, Coach Rob, I get Coach Rob still now talking, said, Jim Hill, you just made an excuse for the line. And that's what Coach Lee did, he took up for his office line. Coach Ford, I spent a year with Coach Ford before he left to go to Howard University, and he tried to take me with him. But I said, I stay at Grambling. But as I look back at, you know, where I look at from Grambling, you don't have to play with anybody in this room if you're from Grambling. If you're from Grambling, you play together anyway.
That's right.
Because I never met a Grambling night that I didn't feel like I was part of, whether that was basketball, baseball, or football. And as I come back, my first time around was basically for my career as a coach. But the second time around was a little different for me because I had some other opportunities. You know, I was just in Washington, D.C. on Wednesday, and with Bruce Allen, the general manager of Redskins, and during the Super Bowl, I met with him and Owen. At that time, I didn't know the coach was leaving. I didn't know Broadway was leaving. So actually, I was on my way out of Tampa and back to D.C. to work for the Redskins, and when the situation came up, I thought about Grambling, not about my career, because you know, I probably had a long career in the NFL just sitting in the front office and coaching young men today because you got to chase them around. But I thought coming back home was the most important thing to me. Not only because it's coming home, but it's Grambling. I got a chance to coach my son, but also come back and be a part of what I've always been a part of. You know, Mr. Adolph Burden has been up here twice. You know, I can honestly say that Coach Rob, in 1973, Coach Rob never saw me play football. You know, they all first came to my house to let me know I was going to Grambling. And he did not only me, but he did a lot of folks there. You're talking about a guy that's 90 years old that bleeds black and gold. I think that in itself speaks volumes. But I think the time for us as a group is to go back to Grambling, rather around Grambling and let the younger guys know. When I first got to Grambling in March, the first thing I did was I got to spin 100 yards of glory. How many people spin 100 yards of glory? And the first thing I did, I made all the guys watch 100 yards of glory. I did it because, not because they know anybody on the film, but I wanted them to understand the history and the legacy of Grambling State University. You know, when I look at Grambling, I look back there with an old football field, it hurt me to my heart that they took that down, all the way down, because to me, that's hollow ground. You know, when you think about the number of people that walked those grounds, I think it speaks volumes. When you walk into the Ed Robinson Museum and look on the wall, now the guys, see, when I think about Coach Robinson and Fred Hall, I don't think about the guys that went on to play pro football. I think about the number of guys that don't play pro football. Who lies that they touch? You know, when you talk about a family tree, Grambling has a family tree probably bigger than anybody in this whole country. You know, when you think about the people who gone to Grambling, their family gone to Grambling, the kids gone to Grambling. And when I got back to Grambling, I looked at my roster, and my roster was 65% out of state. And something missing there.
Right.
You know, I'm afraid to believe it's hard to know Grambling to bleed like it's all be part of Grambling if 65% of your roster is out of state. Don't get me wrong, you got to have some out of state guys, because there's going to be some players you don't want to pass up. But for the most part, you know, when you look in this room, you got New Orleans, you got Lake Charles, you got Baton Rouge, Zach, you got on. You got out-of-state guys too. But at the end of the day, you want people that get in their car on Saturday morning, drive around, and be supported, be a part of it. And that's what I'm hoping And that's what I like to bring back. It's a little tough today when you deal with the young guys as far as recruiting because they got so many other places to go. But at the end of the day, you take the guys that want to be there, the guys that can play, and you do what we've been doing all our life, and that's being part of Grambling, that's being winning. And that's my objective at Grambling now, is to come back and hopefully, the only way I leave Grambling, they got to mow the whole school down, because I have no plans of coming here. So coming down here to read, just to see all the faces and to shake hands with guys that I follow behind, whether or not it's a tree of knowledge down there by the union. You can't sit on that wall anymore by the cafeteria, it's gonna tore it down. But just walking the campus and ground, that means a lot to me that people in this room that I'm standing in front of, you know, they paved the path for me to come to ground and be a part of the legacy and the history of Grambling, and that's something that I'll never forget. I just want to say thank you for inviting me, and next year when the days are crossing out like everybody else, because I think it's important that we find a way, you know, like back in the days when Rose Park, I watched the movie not long ago, you know, when they got something done in Alabama with the strike, the tax strike, it takes a lot of people to get it done. And that's the same way at Grambling. You know, over the last few years, Grambling has been Grambling. I think it's time that we get back to being Grambling, to go to the Grambling way. And I hope that we can support here like you can support now. Not only here, but all of Grambling. We need to come together as a one and let the people in the state of Louisiana and everybody else know that Grambling is here to stay. We don't need any politicians saying we should burn it.